Hello friends, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and safe at home. Today I am going to discuss about the solutions of the previous year PGT English questions which comes under OPSC. So welcome all of you to this channel. Okay, see the video from first went. So what is the questions about? At first you look at the test booklet here. I am discussing the questions from part B, subject English, total mark 100 and time is 2 hours. And look at here, these are coming under your part A, which are consisting of 50 marks. So total mark is 100 plus 50 is equal to 150. And these are the instructions for you. Total 10 instructions are there. You have to read all these instructions one by one, okay? And now comes to your question number 1. Look at here, from question number 1 to 3, these are passage related questions, okay? And this is the passage. Look and read the passage carefully, and now I am discussing the questions, okay? First is question number 1. What is the main idea of the passage? Options are: an ecosystem is a community that includes animals, plants and microscopic bacteria. Option number B: human activities can do great damage to local ecosystems, so human communities should be cautiously planned. And option number C is: in managing the ecology of an area, it is important to protect both human interest and the interest of the members of local ecosystems. D option: people should remember that they are part of the ecosystems where they live and work. Dear friends, here option number B is the correct answer here. Next is question number 2. That is, which of the following best sums up activities within an ecosystem? Options are: predator-prey relationships, interactions among all members, human-animal interactions, human relationship with the environment. Here option number B is the correct answer. Next is question number 3. An ecosystem can most accurately be defined as a geographical area, community, habitat or protected environment. Here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 4. Dear friends, look at here, question number 4 and 5 are related to prepositions. So now question number 4, this is a comfortable house to live days, for, with, in, on. Here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 5, look at here, I haven't been to the theater days a long time, since, for, from, after. Option number B is the correct answer. Dear friend, you all know that we use for a period of time and we use since for a point of time, okay? So here option number B is the correct answer. Next is your question number 6. Look at here. In which of the following novels of Charles Dickens, Little Nell figures as the helpless Victorian female victim? Options are The Old Curiosity Shop, Hard Times, The Pickwick Papers and Oliver Twist. Here option number 1, first one is the correct answer. That is The Old Curiosity Shop, okay? Dear friends, The Old Curiosity Shop is a novel which is written by Charles Dickens and is published between 1840 and 41. You have to remember here that it was printed in a book form in the year 1841, okay? And also remember about the plot or the important characters. Likewise, Little Nell is the main character. Little Nell or Nell Trent is the main character of the novel The Old Curiosity Shop. Other important characters are Nell's grandfather, Christopher Kit Nobles, Daniel Quilp, Richard Dick Swiveller and the single gentleman. Okay, so here right answer is option number A, The Old Curiosity Shop. Next is question number 7. That is, who among the metaphysical poets compares his doctors to cosmographers and himself to their map? Options are Andrew Marvell, George Herbert, John Donne, Henry Vaughan. Here option number C, that is John Donne, is the correct answer. Dear friends, you all know that John Donne is an important metaphysical poet, or he is well known as a metaphysical poet. He had written one poem, the name of the poem is I Mean to God, My God in My Sickness. In that poem, when you go through the 7th line there, he mentioned that he compares his doctors to cosmographers and himself to their maps. Okay, so option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 8. Which sentence best describes the Victorian compromise? Options are, there was an enormous difference between Victorian values and the reality of Victorian life. Option B is the upper classes did not want to make compromises to help lower classes. And option number C is the lower working classes did not want to improve their position. D option, there was a huge contrast between the public and private lives of Victorians. Dear friends, here option number A is the correct answer. This one, first one is the correct answer. Next is question number 9. This one, the term stream of consciousness was first discussed as a concept by whom? Henry James, Virginia Woolf, William James and Oscar Wilde. Here option number C is the correct answer. That is William James. Okay. Dear friends, the term stream of consciousness is mentioned in the book The Principles of Psychology, which is published in the year 1890. Okay. Next is question number 10. Identify the author of the rise of the novel Studies in Defoe, Richardson, Fielding. Options are Claude Rowson, Ian Ward, Janet Todd and John Mullan. Here option number B is the correct answer. That is Ian Ward. Okay. Next is question number 11. Which Savian play contains the idea of a life force? Options are Pygmalion, Candida, Heartbreak House and Man and Superman. Here option number A is the correct answer. That is Pygmalion. Dear friends, here I want to say that Savian play. What is the meaning of Savian play? Savian play means South play. Which South here? South stands for George Bernard Shaw. So Pygmalion is written by George Bernard Shaw, where or in which it contains the idea of a life force. Okay. Next is question number 12. That is, identify the author of the poem The Darkling Thoughts. Options are Dylan Thomas, Matthew Arnold, Thomas Hardy and Ted Hughes. Dear friends, here option number C, that is Thomas Hardy, is the correct answer. Here also you have to know that the original name of The Darkling Thoughts is The Century and 1900. Next is question number 13. Who coined the term pathetic fallacy? Options are Thomas Carlyle, John Ruskin, Alfred Tennyson and Robert Browning. Option number B, that is John Ruskin, is the correct answer. Who had coined the term pathetic fallacy? Here you have to remember that the term pathetic fallacy is mentioned in the book Modern Painter, which is written between 1843 to 1860. Okay. Next question is question number 14. Which among the following is not a thesis play? Options are Galsworthy, The Silver Box, Saw, Mrs. Warren's Profession, Sinji, The Playboy of the Western World and option D, Eves and a Doll's House. Dear friends, here option number B is the correct answer. So here I want to say that the meaning of thesis play. What is the meaning of thesis play? Thesis play means a problematic play. Okay. Next is question number 15. That is, which among the following plays does not belong to the theatre of the absurd? Options are Adam of Ping Pong, Wesker Chicken Soup with Barley, option C Beckett Waiting for Godot and D is Ionesco The Bold Soprano. Dear friends, here option number B is the correct answer, that is Wesker. Okay. Here I want to say that the word theatre of absurd, look at here, theatre of absurd is the word which is coined by Martin Esslin. And here some writers are included. So important writers who are included here are Samuel Beckett, Ionesco, Jean Genet, Harold Pinter and Adamov. Okay. Next is question number 16. What is the quality associated with the Marvelian hero Barabbas? So at first we should know about the quality. Here quality of the Marvelian hero Barabbas is power hungry. It means he desires to have power over his enemies. So now look at the options here. First option is to acquire limitless wealth. Next is to possess all knowledge. C option to travel to distant lands. And D option to conquer the whole world. Dear friends, here option number A is the correct option here. Correct answer is option number A. Here is the first one is the correct answer. Next is question number 17. King James version of the Bibles was published in days 1608, 1617, 1611 or 1604. Option number C is the correct answer. Here also you should know about that the King James version is also called as the authorized version. Okay. Next is question number 18. Sir Fopling is a character in days Congreve's The Way of the World, Ethergis, the man of mood, and Fuckwurst, the recruiting officer, and option D, Bangroves, the replace or the relapse. Here option number B is the correct answer. Okay, next is question number 19. Beauty is truth, truth beauty. That is all ye know on earth and all ye need to know. The above lines occur in kids' days. Options are ode to a nightingale, to autumn, ode to melancholy, and ode on a Grecian urn. Dear friends, here option number D is the correct answer. And here also you should remember about that ode on a Grecian urn is written by Keats in the year 1820. Here he describes about a nun, that how a nun depicts the truth of humankind and that of life. Okay. Next is question number 20. Which romantic poet wrote a pamphlet entitled The Necessity of Atheism or Aestheism? Options are Byron, Shelley, Black, or Coleridge. Option number B, Shelley, is the correct answer. Here Shelley means P.B. Shelley, or we can say Percy V.C. Shelley. So Percy V.C. Shelley have entitled it in the year or printed it in the year 1811. Okay. Next is question number 21. Dear friends, from question number 21 to 30, these are related to grammar. Okay. So first look at the questions of 21. If I dash to Bhubaneswar, I will visit Jiju. Options are went, have gone, am going, and go. Here option number D is the correct answer. Because we know that as will is there. So after if, we use just the present simple form of the verb. Okay. Next is question number 22. That is, they dash on time if they hadn't missed the train. Options are would arrive, will arrive, might have arrived, and should arrive. Here option number C is the correct answer. Here also, according to the rule, we know that after if clause, if had and third form of verb is there, then we should use might or would or should or then have plus third form of the verb. Okay. So here according to the rule, option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 23. Could you turn the SDTV? The cricket match is about to start. Options are back, on, off, out. Option number B is the correct answer. That is turn on. We know that the phrasal verb turn on means switch on. Next question number 24. That is the company is taking days new workers to meet the projected demand. Options are over, out, up, and on. Here option number C is the correct answer. We know that the phrasal verb take up means become interested and engaged. Okay. Next is question number 25. That is, he does not ask for a rise of for fear of losing his job. Options are there, then need, should, need, ought, and might. Dear friends, here option number A, that is there, is the correct answer. Near job we use most of the time there. Okay. Next is question number 26. That is, does you like another cup of coffee? Should, could, would, or may? That is option number C. Would is the correct answer. Dear friends, in polite request or whenever we ask someone for something, then at that time we use the correct verb, that is would. Next is question number 27. Promise me that you will phone me days you get to the railway station. Options are in case, until, as soon as, or while. Here option number C is the correct answer, that is as soon as. Next is question number 28. This is related to your direct and indirect speech. Question is choose the indirect speech for the following sentence. Question is, I said to him, why are you working so hard? Four options are there. Okay, look at the options here. And here, as within the inverted comma, the sentence is in present progressive. So when we change the sentence from direct to indirect, it changes into past progressive. So accordingly, it became wrong, option A and option D. And B, from B and C, you have to choose that which one is the correct answer. And when we change the indirect speech from direct to indirect, at that time we use subject after the WH word. Okay. Why? Because at the end we use the full stop here. So accordingly, option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 29. It is also related to your direct and indirect speech. Question is, choose the direct speech for the following sentence. Question is, I warned her that I could no longer tolerate her coming late. So what will be the answer here? Option number, look at here. As her is there, she is not be there. So it became wrong. My also not we use here. So it also became wrong. Here it also again her, it also became wrong. So option number D is the correct answer. Okay. Next is question number 30. It is also related to your direct and indirect speech. Look at here. Choose the indirect speech for the following sentence. Question is, I reiterated, I don't care about the job. When we change it into indirect speech, then that comes after reiterated. That look at here in option B. That comes, then here do not change to did not. So option number B is correct answer. Okay. Next is question number 31. Dear friends, from question number 31 to 33, these are also related to your passage. And this is the passage. Read the passage carefully. A long passage is given here. Read the passage and now I am going to discuss the questions. First is your 31 number. It is clear from the passage that dolphins days. Option A. Don't want to be with us as much as we want to be with them. B is, are proven to be less intelligent than once thought. C is, have a reputation for being friendly to humans. D is, are the most powerful creatures that live in the oceans. Dear friends, here option number, your C number is the correct answer. This one, C number, okay. Next is 32 number question. The fact that the writer of the passage thinks that we can kill dolphins more easily than they kill us. What are the options here? First option is, means that they are better adapted to their environment than we are. B is, shows that dolphins have a very sophisticated form of communication. C number, proves that dolphins are not the most intelligent species at sea. And D number, does not mean that we are superior to them. Here, option number A is the correct answer. Next is question number 33. One can offer from the reading that days. First is, dolphins are quite abundant in some areas of the world. B is, communication is the most fascinating aspect of the dolphins. C is, dolphins have skills that no other living creatures have, such as the ability to think. And D is, dolphins have some special traits are similar to those of humans. Dear friends, here option number last one is the correct answer, that is D. Next is question number 34. Which of the following best defines the concept of hubris? Option number A, overweening presumption that leads a person to disregard the divinity or the divinely fixed limits on human action in an ordered cosmos. And option number B is here, that excessive pride that leads a person to position himself as either God or evil. C option, the ability to discern divinity in all things terrestrials and human. D option, the tendency to attribute all human flaws to the fallen sinful state of humanity. Dear friends, here option number A, first one is the correct answer. Next is question number 35. In poetics, Aristotle uses the term peripeter to designate the shift of tragic protagonist fortune. Options are given here, from ephemeral to eternal, from bad to good, from good to bad, or from eternal to ephemeral. Dear friends, here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 36. Which two factors were regarded as crucial by writers owing allegiance to naturalism? Options are instinct and intuition, heredity and environment, instinct and environment, intuition and heredity. Dear friends, here option number B is the correct answer. Next is question number 37. Who coined the term poetic justice? Options are Jean Racine, Samuel Johnson, Thomas Rymer and Denis Diderot. Dear friends, here option number C is the correct answer. That is Thomas Rymer. Dear friends, here I want to say that the term poetic justice, here poetic justice is written in his work Tragedies of the Last Age, which is written in the year 1677. Okay. Next is question number 38. Here is question number 38. to Plato, the poet as man and poetry as a form of statement both seemed dead. Options are unnecessary, B option untrustworthy, option C sublime, and option D praiseworthy. Here option number B is the correct answer. Next is 39 number. The ends of tragedy as Aristotle conceived them are best served by the harmonious disposition of six elements, which among the following is not one of them. Options are stage, plot, character, and song. Dear friends, here you have to remember about the six elements. Okay, what are the six elements? First one is plot, then character, then diction, thought, spectacle, and song or music. So according to this list, stage is not there. So stage is the answer here. Okay, next is question number 40. Look at here. Which American playwright used expressionist dramatic techniques? Options are Henry Miller, Eugene O'Neill, Edward Albee, and Sam Shepard. Here option number B is the correct answer. That is Eugene O'Neill. Dear friends, here I want to say that two writers are famous. First one is Eugene O'Neill and second one is Elmer Rice. Okay, these two writers are famous for dramatic techniques. Okay, next is question number 41. In his observations on tragedy, Aristotle emphasizes which one unity? Action, time, place, or all unities are given equal emphasis? Dear friends, here option number A is the correct answer. We can say action or plot. Okay, next is question number 42. Here is question number 42. Which English poet penned the first English Surrealist Manifesto in French in Paris, and it was published in a French review? Options are F.S. Flint, Roy Fuller, David Gascony, and Geoffrey Grigson. Option number A is the correct answer. Dear friends, here F.S. Flint means Frank Stuart Flint. Okay, who was an English poet and translator, and also a prominent member of the Imagist group. Okay, next one is question number 43 here. In which of his essays T.S. Eliot set forth his concept of objective correlative? Options are Tradition and Individual Talent, Hamlet and His Problems, The Perfect Critic, or Swinburne as Poet. Here option number B is the correct answer. Dear friends, here I want to say that objective correlative is a term which is popularized by T.S. Eliot in his essay. The name of the essay is Hamlet and His Problems. Okay. Next is question number 44. This one. Although Eliot is credited with making the term objective correlative known in modern critical vocabulary, it was originally used in 19th century by Fenton to suggest the relation between the mind and the external world. Who is the Fenton? Options are Albert Pinkham Ryder, then Thomas Cole, then Henry Inman, and Washington Allston. Dear friends, here option number D, Washington Allston, is the correct answer. Next is question number 45. In Greek mythology, who flew too close to the sun? Options are Icarus, Pegasus, Theseus, or Proteus. Here option number A, Icarus, is the correct answer. Dear friends, here you have to know about Icarus, that in Greek mythology, he was the son of the inventor Daedalus, who persisted by flying too near the sun with waxen wings. Okay, next is question number 46. Who was the chief god of the ancient Greeks? Apollo, Zeus, Perseus, or Dionysus? Option number B is the correct answer here, that is Zeus. Next is question number 47. Which of the following literary movements was concerned with clear, direct expression? Options are Imagism, Surrealism, Dadaism, and New Classicism. Dear friends, here Imagism is the correct answer because Imagism is a literary movement, okay, in the early 20th century. And you have to remember about the Surrealism, which is a your cultural movement which develops in Europe. Okay, and it is best known for its visual art workers and writings. Next is your Dadaism. Dadaism is an art movement of the Europe. It is also it a act movement. Then your New Classicism is a Western cultural movement. Okay, so option number A is the correct answer here. Next is your question number 48. What is the name of a name for a record of a period in a person's life? Options are volume, fiction, diary or short story. Here option number C, that is diary, is the correct answer. Dear friends, similar word of diary is log. Okay. Next is question number 49. Which of these writers often deals with the experience of the Indian immigrants to the US? Options are Salman Rushdie, then Rabindranath Tagore, then J.D. Smith or Jhumpa Lahiri. Option number D, Jhumpa Lahiri, is the correct answer. Dear friends, Jhumpa Lahiri is the daughter of the Bengali immigrants. Okay. Next is question number 50. Which historical event permits the plot of Dickens' Tale of Two Cities? Options are the American Revolution, then is your Russian Revolution, French Revolution or your Belgaum Revolution. Dear friends, here option number C, that is the French Revolution, is the correct answer. Here I want to say that Tales of Two Cities is written by Dickens, which is a historical novel. It is set in London and Paris before and during the French Revolution. So, answer is option number C, French Revolution. Next is question number 51. This is the study of meanings. Options are stylistics, semantics, semiotics or symbolism. Option number B is the correct answer here. Next is question number 52. When the title of a poem begins with the phrase "in memory of," we expect it to be an epic, elegy, encomium or essay. Option number B here is the correct answer. Next is question number 53. The Renaissance was a period of renewed interest in this. The supernatural and occult, mysticism and religion, classical learning and arts, tribal and folk wisdom. Here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 54. Which poem by W.B. Yeats begins with the line "This is no country for old men"? Options are Byzantium, Sailing to Byzantium, Adam's Course or Lapis Lazuli. Option number B is correct answer here. Dear friends, here also I want to say that Sailing to Byzantium, if we look the poem which is written by W.B. Yeats, the first line of the poem is written as "This is no country for old men." Okay. Next question is your question number 55. This is metafiction is this. Look at here the options. Options are that to which the readers draw their attention by a deliberate prolific strategy. Second option is that to which the commentators draw our attention by cross references and citations. Option number C, fiction that draws attention to itself as an artifact in order to pose questions about fiction and reality. And D option is that is premised or premised upon an artifact that deflects obsessive concern with the nature of fiction and reality. Dear friends, here option number D is the correct answer. Next is question number 56. Look at here. In deconstructive terminology, the term aporia does not suggest, first option, the sense of a final paradox, B option, a point of which a text's self-contradictory meanings can no longer be resolved, C option, a point at which a text meanings are finally decidable, D option, a point at which a text undermines its most fundamental presuppositions. Dear friends, here option number A is the correct answer because it is called as dialetheia. Next is question number 57. In Derrida's coining of the term difference, there is a combination of option A, difference and differel, option number B is difference and difference, option number C is difference and inference, option number D is difference and sufferance. Dear friends, here option number A, that is difference and differel, is the here. This one is the correct answer. Next is question number 58. New historicism suggests a trend in American literary studies in the 1980s, led by whom? Options are Louis Montrose, Jonathan Goldberg, and Stephen Greenblatt, and Jerome McGann. Here option number C is the correct answer here. Next is question number 59 here. Who among the following is not associated with post-colonial theory? Options are Homi Bhabha, Frederick Jepson, Edward Said, and Gayatri Spivak. Which one is the correct option here? Option number B is the correct option here. Okay. Next is question number 60. Who is the author of the postmodern condition? Options are Jacques Lacan, Gilles Deleuze, Jean-Francois Lyotard, and Jean Baudrillard. Option number C is the correct option here. Okay. Who is a French philosopher? Next is question number 61. Which of the following is not associated with high modernism in the novel? Options are stream of consciousness, the mythical method, narrative realism, and free indirect style. Option number C is correct here. Okay. Next is question number 62. With which enormously influential perspective or practice is the early 20th century thinker Sigmund Freud associated? Options are eugenics, psychoanalysis, and phrenology, and your anarchism. Option number B, that is psychoanalysis, is the correct answer. Dear friends, you all know that Sigmund Freud is the father of psychoanalysis. Okay. And next is question number 63. Which metrical form was Alexander Pope said to have brought to perfection? Options are heroic couplet, black horse, the ode, or the spondee. Option number A is the correct option here. Okay. Next is question number 64. In an 1817 letter, the English poet John Keats amplified the idea of negative capability. Who was mentioned by Keats to have possessed this ability in abundant measure? Options are Shakespeare, Spenser, Milton, or Dryden. Option number A is the correct option here. Next is question number 65. Which of the following statement is true? Option number A, structuralism attempts to interpret what an individual text means. Next is option number B, structuralism acknowledges the importance of the author. Next is structuralism is concerned with how meanings are created. D option, structuralism makes an attempt to decide whether a work is good or bad. Dear friends, here option number C is the correct option. Correct here. Okay. Next is question number 66. Antonio Gramsci shifted the focus of Marxist analysis through which of the following ideas? First one is hegemony is a product of the lack of class conflict. B option is that consent for a particular social and political system was produced and reproduced through the operation of hegemony. C option, hegemony is a product of humanity gaining power over nature. And D option, that hegemony attempts to challenge the prevailing order that legitimates an unjust system. Dear friends, here option number A is the correct answer. Next is question number 67. In structuralism, the relationship between the sign and what it refers to is this: necessary, identical, arbitrary, or opposite. Option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 68. Who among the following proposed that all female characters in literature are in at least one of the following stages of development: the feminine, feminist, or female stage? Options are Elanine Soulter, Julia Kristeva, Virginia Woolf, or Toril Molin. Option number A is the correct answer here. Next is question number 69. That is, new criticism argues that the dash is the primary source of meaning, word, sentence, text, or metaphor. Option number C is the correct answer here. Next is question number 70. Dash criticizes new historists for reducing literature to historical footnotes. Options are Terry Eagleton, Harold Bloom, William Empson, and Frank Kermode. Option number B is the correct answer here. Next is question number 71. Composed upon Westminster Bridge, September 3, 1802, is a sonnet written by Dash. Coleridge, Wordsworth, Black, or Byron. Here option number B is the correct answer. Wordsworth means William Wordsworth. Okay. Next is question number 72. Thomas Gray's The Progress of Poesy is an example of this. Options are Pindaric Ode, Horacian Ode, and C option is your Sophic Ode or Anarkinian Ode. Which one is the correct answer? That is option number A, first one. Next is question number 73. That is John Milton's Lucidas is an this. Epithalamion, Ecologue, Elegy, or Epilion. Option number C is the correct option here. Okay. नेक्स्ट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 74. व्हाट इज देयर इन क्वेश्चन 74? जॉन ड्राइडेंस द कॉन्क्वेस्ट ऑफ ग्रैनडा इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस. रोमांटिक कॉमेडी, ट्रेजिक कॉमेडी एंड सिनिकन ट्रेजेडी और हीरोइक ट्रेजेडी. डियर फ्रेंड्स, हियर ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. हियर हीरोइक ट्रेजेडी. Here I want to say that the Conquest of Granada is a Restoration era stage play. Okay. Next is question number 75. That is verse liver translated into English is this: syllabic verse, free verse, rimmed verse, or blank verse. Option number B here is correct answer. Next is question number 76. Which one among the following is a picaresque novel? Options are Swans and Lovers, Mrs. Dalloway, Moll Flanders or Pamela. Here option number C, that is Moll Flanders, is the correct option. Okay. Next is question number 77. Charles Lamb's Dream Children is an example of this: periodical essay, informal essay, polyphonic prose or philosophical essay. Here option number B, informal essay, is the correct answer. Dear friends, informal essays are also called as personal essays. Next is question number 78 here. That is the term epiphany is associated with whom among the following modernist writers? Options are James Joyce, Ezra Pound, T.S. Eliot or Wyndham Lewis. Option number A is the correct option here. That is James Joyce. Okay. Dear friends, the term epiphany was made popular by James Joyce. Next is question number 79. Which of the following is not part of the details of the setting of the Gothic novel genre? Options are dungeons, omens, sunlit streets or menstrual status. Here option number A is the correct answer here. Okay. Gothic novel means historical novels. Next is question number 80. In Sophocles, Oedipus vows to punish the slayer of the old king, unaware that he is condemning himself. This is an example of this: irony of fate, dramatic irony, irony of situation or Socratic irony. Here option number B, that is dramatic irony, is the correct answer. Next is question number 81. Edward Said's Orientalism was published in this: 1975, 1980, 1978 or 1983. Here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 82. Who among the following is not a new critic? Options are Ellen Tate, W.K. Wimsett, Clint Brooks or Edmund Wilson. Here answer is option number A, this one. Next is question number 83. Who had coined the term expression gynocritics? Options are Germaine Greer, Kate Millett, Elena Swalter or Julia Kristeva. Which one is the correct answer? Here option number C, this one is the correct answer. Okay. Next is 84. With which of the following movements was Jacques Lacan briefly associated? Options are Vorticism, Surrealism, Imagism or Cubism. Here option number 84 B, Surrealism, is the correct answer. Okay. Next is question number 85. Who has introduced and elaborated on the concept of ideological state apparatus? Options are Louis Althusser, Walter Benjamin, Antonio Gramsci or Raymond Williams. Here answer is option number A. Next is question number 86. Dear friends, look at here from question number 86 to 90. One poem is given here and accordingly questions are given here from 86 to 90. Okay, so first read the poem carefully and now I am discussing the question. First one is 86, this one. The evening star rises when the birds leave their nest. It is midnight, it is dawn, the sun descends in the west. Here option number D is the correct answer. Okay. Next is question number 87. Here bower represents this: a potted plant, a framework that supports climbing plants, a bouquet of flowers, a flower vase. Here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 88. The angels come down on earth to this: spread moonlight, give blessings and joy, make people dance and make fun, take blessings and joy. Option number B Here is the correct answer. Next is question number 89. Bird's nest is described as thoughtless because option A, angels are blessings the birds to be happy. Next is the birds are covered in the warmth of their nest. C is it is made without any thought. And D is the occupants are asleep without any care. Option number D here is the correct answer. Next is question number 90. The figure of speech used in line 6 in heaven's high bower is this: metaphor, personification, alliteration or simile. Option number A, that is metaphor, is the correct option here. Next is question number 91. Which work by Jonathan Swift is reputed to have prevented an English currency fraud in Ireland? Options are The Battle of Books, A Tale of a Tube, Modest Proposal or A Drapier's Letters. Option number D, Drapier's Letters, is the correct answer. Next one is question number 92. That is William Wordsworth Prelude is a blank verse memoir in Days Books 10, 14, 12, 8. Option number C is the correct answer here. Next is question number 93. Which of the following is a dystopian novel? Options are Treasure Islands, then The Moonstone, Erihon or The Woodlanders. Option number C is the correct option here. Okay. Next is question number 94. In his essay, The Metaphysical Poets, T.S. Eliot credited an English poet with a unified sensibility in which thoughts and feelings were not dissociated. Who was the poet? George Herbert, William Shakespeare, Ben Jonson or John Donne. Option number D is the correct answer. Next is question number 95. What is the subtitle of Samuel Richardson's Pamela? Options are Virtue Rewarded, Virtue Revealed, Love's Logic or A Tale of London. Option number A is the correct option here. Okay. Next is question number 96. Bakishrov is a character in this. Tom Jones, Sense and Sensibility, Hard Times or Vanity Fair. Option number D, here is the correct answer, Vanity Fair. Dear friends, Vanity Fair is a novel which is written by William Makepeace Thackeray. Okay. Next is question number 97. Look at here. Who among the following adapted Shakespeare's King Lear in 1681 to give it a happy ending in which Edgar married Cordelia? John Dryden, Samuel Johnson, Nahum Tate or Alexander Pope? Dear friends, here option number C is the correct answer. Next is question number 98. The Muses were Des goddesses in Greek mythology 5, 7, 3 or 9. Option number D is the correct option here. Okay. Next is question number 99. Thomas Keats' The Spanish Tragedy is an example of what? New classical tragedy, revenge tragedy, domestic tragedy or romantic tragedy? Dear friends, here option number B is the correct answer. Okay. Dear friends, here I want to say this. The Spanish Tragedy is an Elizabethan tragedy which is written by Thomas Kidd between 1582 and 1592. And it is a revenge play, or we can say revenge tragedy. Okay. Next is question number 100. Who among the following was the proponent and theorist of the theater of cruelty? Options are Albert Camus, Samuel Beckett, Antonin Artaud, or Luigi Pirandello. Here option number C is the correct answer here. Antonio Artaud. Okay. So my dear friends, these are all about the solutions of the previous year PGT English questions that comes under OPSC. See the video from first to last. I have discussed briefly about the questions from part B, that is from question 1 to question 100, total 100 mark. So see the video carefully and be prepared for your upcoming exam. Okay, that's all. Thank you.